So all throughout today, we've been exploring the theme, moving mountains. I want to continue on that path by talking about overcoming your mountains. You see, the word mountain here is used in symbolic terms, and it represents obstacles, challenges, problems that we all face in the journey through life. You see, the concept of facing and overcoming obstacles is nothing new. Those that came before us had mountains to climb, just as we too have mountains to overcome in our lives. The problem is when mountains appear, they are usually a matter of perspective. So one person sees it a certain way, while somebody else sees something completely different. Take the word impossible, for example. When most people look at it, they see it as it spells, impossible. And they translate that to mean it can't be done. Or in extreme cases, run. Now somebody else looks at the same set of letters, but sees something completely different. They see, I am possible. And they translate that to mean, it can be done. Or, embrace me. It is all a matter of perspective. On December 17, 1903, something special happened right here in North Carolina. Orville and Wilbur Wright achieved the first powered, sustained, and controlled airplane flight. Today, you could easily jump on a plane, and in a matter of hours, you could be in Brazil, France, Italy, Japan, Nigeria, South Africa, Ghana, and many other interesting locations around the world. We owe that in part to these two men for making it possible. What many might not know is, prior to the Wright brothers taking flight, many thought it was impossible. One of the best known examples was Lord Kelvin. Rated as one of the world's greatest physicists, he said, and I quote, "Heavier than air flying machines are impossible," end quote. Impossible, he said. Now, the Wright brothers could have chosen to dwell on those words, but they didn't. Instead, they went on to have the first successful flight. Many will tell you that the mountains in your life cannot be moved. They will tell you it is impossible. But you have to make a conscious decision to focus on the task at hand. Many told the Wright brothers it was impossible, and already went over the example of Lord Kelvin. But when Lord Kelvin saw the word impossible, the Wright brothers saw, I am possible. It is also interesting to note that Lord Kelvin died on December 17, 1907, exactly 4 years to the day the Wright brothers first took flight. Isn't that pretty cool? So, perspective is such a powerful thing. And it's important for us to know that we all see the world through different lenses. And those lenses are shaped by our beliefs, our culture, our environment, and so forth. Even something as constant as the sun can be viewed differently depending on who you ask or where you are. You see, I grew up in Nigeria, And Nigeria has primarily two seasons, the rainy season and the dry season. In the rainy season, it rains, and in the dry season, it's dry. Pretty simple, right? During the dry season, in some parts of the country, it gets really hot. So hot that you seldom see people outside. It is not until the sun goes down and things start to cool down that you see most people outside. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever seen someone with an umbrella in the middle of the day when it's not raining? That's how hot it gets. So imagine what I thought when I first moved to the United States. I remember it was in the spring after a very cold winter. And I remember this particular day, it was hot. And everybody was outside. I mean, you had guys outside with no shirts on, showing up their muscles and their six packs. And you had some showing off their not so six packs. You had people laying in the grass, just basking in the sun. People were throwing frisbee. And everybody was having a great time. It felt like a party outside. And then people walked up to me and said, "Isn't it a gorgeous day? Isn't it beautiful outside today?" And I couldn't help but think to myself, this is not my idea of a gorgeous or a beautiful day. It is hot. You see, perspective, it's an important thing. And it's important for us to know that when mountains appear in our lives, there is always the possibility of seeing it differently. I run into people all the time that say, "I'm just a waiter. I'm just a tailor. I'm just a student. I don't have what it takes to move mountains. I don't have what it takes to do anything special in my life." Consider this. Neither Orville or Wilbur Wright went to college. In fact, they worked at a bicycle shop. They were bicycle repairmen. They could easily have said, "All we do is fix bicycles. We're not worthy. We don't have what it takes to build a plane." But instead, they went on to build and have the first successful flight. One of the reasons the Wright brothers were successful was because they were dedicated. They were following their passion. See, when they were young, their father, Milton Wright, on return from one of his many trips, gave his two sons a toy helicopter. That simple gift began a lifelong passion for flying. What are you passionate about? You might just be a waiter, a tailor, or just a student. But you're not inadequate. You are capable of doing amazing things. One big mistake is to solely look at yourself as you are today to make a judgment on what's possible in your life in the future. I'm going to repeat that. A big mistake is to solely look at yourself as you are today to make a judgment on what's possible in your life in the future. Instead, you should ask yourself, who is the kind of person I need to be so such a thing is possible? Who is the kind of person I need to be so I can move mountains? Identify these things and pursue them wholeheartedly. The ability to tap into an immense power that lies within us, we all have that ability. But like the Wright brothers did, what is often required is that we focus on the task at hand, regardless of what anyone says or thinks. The ability to be successful and overcome our mountains is not just in some of us, it's in all of us. You will come across mountains in your life that you will not be prepared to move or face. You should not concede to defeat. Know that if you concede to defeat, you are only setting up yourself to fail. Know that there's nothing you cannot learn, no skill you cannot master. But if you concede to defeat, then none of that will be possible. You will come across bumps along the way. Everyone does. Obstacles are a part of life. Obstacles are a part of life. But you can overcome these obstacles. When mountains appear, most people choose to focus on the mountain alone. Instead, you should focus on the solutions and on growing yourself. I'll tell you a secret. When mountains appear, they are only a problem when they are bigger than you. You should focus on growing and developing yourself so much that you become bigger than the mountains that you face. I'm going to repeat that. When mountains appear, they are only a problem when they are bigger than you. But you should focus on growing and developing yourself so much that you become bigger than the mountains that you face. As you grow and develop yourself, the definition of what you consider a mountain changes. You see, obstacles bring along opportunities. But most people don't see the opportunities because they're too focused on the obstacles. It is not until you learn to look past the obstacles that you're able to see the opportunities. Do you ever wonder why some people have such a great perspective on life? It is because they have been to the top of their mountain. And from there, they can see things differently. People ask me, are you going to come across mountains in your life? The answer is yes. When you come across those mountains, will you have the option to turn around and avoid the mountains? The answer is yes. If you do so, however, you will miss the opportunity of learning. You see, it's impossible. We don't use that word. See, you can't climb a mountain without reaching new heights. It is in the process of climbing up that you elevate your mind, elevate your character, elevate your ideals. Some of the best views that you'll ever see are on the mountaintop. And you will only see those views if you embrace and climb up your mountain. So I say, I want you to take a bold step towards climbing your mountain. Not today, right now. Not tomorrow, right now. And I look forward to hearing your success stories. Thank you very much.